afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Happy Sunday, and it's Facebook Live Real Food, our 18th show. That's 1-8. 18th. Katrina, we've been doing this 18 times in a row. Can you believe that?
Bravo.
Katrina's happy about that. We're here with the lovely Katrina, my lovely dog Dugan, and me on our patio. Coming to you live from Mission Viejo. It's a beautiful fall day. It was actually, right now it's 92 degrees here in Mission Viejo. Not exactly what I would call perfect fall weather. But nonetheless, we're here. And we're going to be providing some spectacular, and I don't think I'm over-exaggerating when I say spectacular recipe items tonight. Katrina, would you say that? You look sad. What's the matter?
Nothing.
Oh, you look like you're going to cry.
No.
I know. She's just drug out of the house, you know, and this is it. So if you guys did not know this, today, October 4th, is National Taco Day. That's right, National Taco Day. How many people knew that? Probably not a lot.
Woo!
So an observation of that, we're going to be making stuff with pumpkin tonight because it's the first Sunday in October. And October is typically people make stuff with pumpkin, right? Pumpkin this, pumpkin that, pumpkin spice, cinnamon, nutmeg. It's all over the damn place from now until the end of the year. And quite honestly, I'm not a big super duper fan of pumpkin spice. I don't really enjoy pumpkin spice. Katrina, you like pumpkin spice?
Uh-huh.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
What do you like pumpkin spice in?
Just...
Okay, that's good. So we're going to keep moving around. Okay, it's only a 45-minute show. So, but no, people put pumpkin spice in pumpkin pie, pumpkin muffins, pumpkin mm-hmm. bread.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, today we're going to be making two things that does not include pumpkin spice at all, but it does have pumpkin. We're going to be making some cheese tortellini with pumpkin Alfredo sauce. Now, this is something that Katrina just nabbed off the internet, literally, what, this morning or yesterday?
Yesterday.
Because we're going to make a killer recipe, which is also on our website, realfood.com. It's a pumpkin bread with a macadamia nut crusty top. But being that it's just a 45-minute show, we're trying to figure out logistics of how we're going to do it. So it just wasn't going to work. But if you want a really good pumpkin bread recipe, just check it out at Real Food. Just type in pumpkin bread. It'll pop right up. It's really good. Macadamia nuts on the top. Very moist. And that was the thing I liked about it. So that's what we're not making tonight. Tonight, like I said, we're going to be making some cheese tortellini with pumpkin Alfredo sauce. And also we're going to make them some spiced pumpkin fritters, deep fried.
Mm-hmm. They're like donut holes.
They're exactly like donut holes, actually. Mm-hmm. If a donut hole had pumpkin in it, it would be a pumpkin, spiced pumpkin
hole.
Fritter. Pumpkin hole would be a pumpkin hole. I don't know. Maybe that'll take us into a whole different show right now. So how are we doing? Any questions, comments, anyone tuning in?
We've got Easy Q, okay. Dave, Carla, and Aunt Diane.
Oh, I meant to mention Diane had a birthday. Didn't she have a birthday last mm-hmm. week? Happy birthday, Diane.
Happy birthday.
47. How old is Diane? 47?
Yeah.
48? 47. If you guys up living up north, Diane is single. Very hot. Check her out. Diane, if you just want to type your phone number, email address, anything you got, your Instagram or your Twitter, wherever you want, so guys can reach you, maybe pop a picture up, right? I don't think that's asking too much.
You might want to ask Aunt Diane.
Well, I'm asking her right now. I mean, I can't call her, so Diane, if you're looking,
she
you have
waved.
A lot of really... What's that?
She did wave.
Oh, she did wave. Okay, so she may be up for that. I don't know. So anyways, you can see we are decorated for Halloween right now. We have our Halloween decorations. So we don't usually keep these out like this, but... tonight is a special occasion because we are coming into October. Can you believe October? We started this in what, June? I think we started doing this in June. Where's the time gone? Katrina's like looking at me like, shut up and cook. I have to be to bed by 8 o'clock, okay? That's all I'm seeing right now. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to start off with, Katrina, am I light enough here? Is the lights okay now?
Yeah, it looks good.
Okay.
But Diane says, what?
Just too much for Diane. Okay. So we're going to start off with something that Katrina just pulled off the internet yesterday. And she showed this to me, and I go, man, this is like perfect. We can do this in a short amount of time, and it's really good. It doesn't involve any meat. This is basically vegan,
yeah.
too, isn't it?
Well, it's cheese tortellini. I'm not sure.
Oh, no, it's got cheese in it. Okay.
Yeah.
So it's not really vegan, but it is vegetarian. right?
Yeah, and we had everything.
It's what?
And we had everything.
And we had everything, too. But it's not surprising because every time we go grocery shopping, we always buy one of everything in the store. So we just got an extra refrigerator and a freezer just so we could make room for more stuff, okay? So it's really kind of a free-for-all when we're looking for something, like a bottle of ketchup. We have to look in like five different locations because it could be anywhere, right? And that's what we did for this, but after going through the whole house, we found that we had everything for tonight's show, basically, except shallots. Did not have shallots. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to be starting off with some cheese tortellini with pumpkin Alfredo sauce. Very, very good, and it's easy to make, too, especially in this fall season. So pay attention. Like I said, all the recipes are right down below there, and also check us out on YouTube. Like us. We always like people to like us and subscribe to us. Very important. We need love. Don't we need love?
Yeah.
Dugan needs love. Don't do it for me. Don't do it for Katrina. Do it for Dugan. Dugan needs love more than anybody.
Yeah. Okay. And we only have three people watching.
And we only have three people. Okay, that's perfect. Well, you know, there could be six people at each location. Right? There's a big night. There's a lot of stuff going on tonight.
Yeah.
I don't know what that is. I don't know what could be bigger than this. But you know what? It doesn't matter. Because, you know, the people that are here right now, those are the most important people. Exactly. And it doesn't bother us, does it? It doesn't really bother us, does it, Katrina?
No.
Okay, so shut up, Tom. Get cooking. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. First of all, we're not going to make tortellini from scratch, okay? We're going to... I bought some tortellini, cheese tortellini, and they have a really good selection over at Costco. Not to give them a plug or anything, but we've eaten these before. And this is a five-cheese tortellini, already made, stuffed, and everything else. I mean, if you guys want to knock yourself out and make these, go right ahead. But you know what? It's not necessary. So we have about 10, 12 ounces here of these tortellinis. We're going to throw these in some boiling water, which just happens to be boiling right now. Perfect timing on that. Okay? And I'm going to put those in right now. And they're only going to take about 2 minutes just to cook. Okay? So we're going to put those in there. And while they are doing their little thing, we're going to put a tablespoon of butter right here in our pan, like this. I already got some butter in there, as you can see. Tortellinis there. Let me make sure I have everything I'm going to need to make this come out perfect. Stir that up really good. Okay. Tortellini, butter. Okay, so then we have a couple shallots. And as you know, I like little shortcuts. So I got one of these. It's a chopper. I can sit here and chop with my knife, you know, but sometimes these things are just nice to have, right?
That's good.
Just put that over there. It's done. It's a super chopper.
Yep.
And depending if you want it coarse, fine. You decide. That's the thing. It's in your hands. It's all up to you. Okay? So, tortellinis are starting to float to the top. Like I said, they only take about 2 minutes. So, we're going to just let them do their thing. Get the butter up here. So, what we're going to do is going to put our shallots right in the melted butter. That's a tablespoon of melted butter. Okay? Going right in there. And let's bring this up a little bit higher because that's what we do here on our show. So, shallots are in, tortellini's cooking. So with the shallots, you just want to have them cook just so they get a little translucent, they're soft, you know, you just want them cooked, you don't want to overcook, you don't want to brown them, but at the same time, you know, you don't want them crunchy, okay? Maybe you do. If you like them crunchy, don't cook them as long. Simple. Okay, so we're going to watch our tortellinis here, and you can't really overcook those. I mean, obviously you don't want them to sit in the water and boil for like a half an hour because that would make no sense. So let's kick that up a little bit higher. Any questions, comments, anything, Katrina?
No. Nancy Carla is watching.
Oh, now Nancy is out here in California today. So so Nancy is separate from Dave. So Nancy is out here. Nancy, how you doing? And Tish is with her, I believe. I think they drove out here. They drove out here, got
and
to see
that. And the rig.
And the rig.
Yeah.
I would like to see that rig sometime.
I know,
it's how they do that, I mean, in the wintertime.
It's great.
I mean, driving a truck.
I know.
At any time of year is hard, but in the wintertime,
the snow,
the cold.
Yeah.
I mean, you would like it.
I would.
You should probably drive with them sometime.
I would love it.
If you guys want to help her, I mean, Katrina can get how much vacation time? You have a couple weeks vacation.
Yeah,
then you go back, drive around with Nancy and Tish, and then you can like unload stuff.
Hook
them
great.
Up. You could be on the CB.
Back up the trailer.
You could be like Jerry Reed in Smoking the Bandit. You
there
get
you
on
go.
There and do the whole thing. So, yeah, so if you guys want a partner, Katrina's a lot of fun, too. Even if she didn't work, just fun to hang around with, okay? What, are you scratching over there? Got mosquitoes out here really bad in Southern California right now. We have a mosquito problem, which is not good. Okay, so enough talking, Tom. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We got the butter in here. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add a, going to put a half a cup of pumpkin puree.
Puree.
My French is not good. Okay, so we're going to put a half a cup of that. You can buy this. I would suggest buying this now if you're going to be making anything over the holidays, because it goes like that. Okay, pumpkin pies. Everyone's making pumpkin stuff. Okay, so we're going to start off with a half a cup. We're going to put that in with the shallots and the butter. Okay? So just measure out a nice half a cup there. I'd like to be precise here. So before I put that in, let me give these guys one last little turn here. That looks pretty good. I got one piece here. It's a little big, but we'll let that cook. Okay, so here we go. Half a cup right there like that. So you can see this is very, very simple. And there you go. We'll put that up to the side there. Let's turn the heat down a little bit on this. You don't want to burn it. You know, you just want to warm it up. Okay, so we're going to get out a little whippy whip here. We're just going to kind of start mixing this in with the butter and the shallots. And this is pretty easy. What do you guys see, the finished product? I mean, it's pretty amazing. Okay, so there you go. You have the pumpkin. And you have that now. And check on these. These are doing good right here. Like I said, they don't need a lot. Okay, these are already kind of cooked. You just want to heat them up all the way through. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to add a little nutmeg in here too. We love nutmeg around the holidays. Nutmeg is always good. You can buy ground nutmeg, or you can be cool like us, and you can buy like the little nutmegs here. They look like little rocks. You just kind of shave it right in here. Just a pinch or two. Ooh, don't put the whole thing in there because that's kind of crunchy. Okay, a little nutmeg in there like that. Okay, give it a little stir. So now all we have right now is we have the butter, the shallots, nutmeg, and pumpkin. Okay, so to that we're going to add a cup and a half of whipping cream, heavy whipping cream. Going to go right in there just like that. Beauteous. Katrina's like covering her legs with calamine lotion right now as I'm cooking dinner.
I'm sorry.
Okay. This is nice. Okay, so there we go. So you can see it's starting to actually take on an orangish color, but it is kind of creamy. So you just want to cook that for a couple minutes. Let that get up to a boil, first of all. Any questions, Katrina, on that?
No.
You're not even looking at the computer now.
I am looking at it.
All you're doing is putting stuff on your legs.
I'm looking at it. There's no questions.
Nothing, huh?
No.
That's what happens a lot of times. People become amazed with what we do here, okay? So these are pretty much close to being done. If you want to try one, you can do that too. But like I said, it's been about 2-3 minutes. I think we're good. Just cut that big bad boy in half. Check it out. That's good.
It's a slow night tonight.
Huh?
It's a slow night tonight.
Slow night tonight. Perfect. And you know what? It's too bad because this could end up being the best show we've ever done. Right?
You think?
Well, I'm feeling real good about it myself. But you know, that's just me. Okay, so we're going to turn the heat off. And I think some people, since maybe we don't have a lot of people watching, maybe they're just feeling guilty now. They don't want to leave because they just want to leave us by ourselves. Mm-hmm. And we appreciate that. So there we go. So the tortellinis are out. Katrina's killing bugs as we speak. Okay. So there you go. The tortellini is hot. So that's going to go into the sauce right here. Just like that. And it will thicken up a little bit. Now what we're going to do is just add a little bit of salt and pepper. Sauce thing's going over there, Katrina.
Good, but...
A little pepper.
Dave Carlos says, I'm spellbound by your artistry.
Which part? Which part did Dave like? Okay, a little salt, a little pepper. Always goes in everything. Not too much. Okay? Just give it a little whippy-do. Like that. Whippy-do is actually a cooking term.
Whippy-do.
Yeah. So there you go. And you know, it's always good too if you want taste. You can use your finger like I do. Or use a spoon. Since it's just Katrina and I here tonight, and we're the only ones going to be eating this, it's okay to use my finger because we both know where my finger has been. It's not like it's been out misbehaving or anything, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, we got incoming, huh? We got an incoming. Okay, so there you go. So that's pretty much done. So the only thing left we have to do right now, and this is really going to make it perfecto, we're going to put a quarter cup of Parmesan cheese in, freshly grated Parmesan cheese, I might add. Quarter of a cup. That's what you're going to need. You can eyeball. I mean, if you like Parmesan cheese, you can add a little bit more. But we'll go for somewhere right around a quarter of a cup. Okay. As you can see, this is all starting to bubble and cook really good. So get that down a little bit lower on the heat. Take the Parmesan cheese, sprinkle that right in there like that. Okay, give it a good little stir. And it will start to thicken up a little bit as the cheese melts. So that's a good thing. Okay, a little bit more cheese, because I like Parmesan cheese. And you know what? It's best to get this stuff here and grate it yourself so you know it's fresh and it's the real stuff. I mean, you can buy this stuff in the store, you know, who knows how long it's been sitting there. But this way you know it's good, you know it's fresh, right?
It's good.
And I think this is going to be a happy meal. Mm. Not a McDonald's happy meal, it's just a happy meal, okay? And as the cheese melts, the consistency of this, and I'll show you guys, I don't think you'll be able to see it too well here, but I'm going to try my best. It's kind of just a sauce. Almost looks like
macaroni and cheese sauce.
Can you set it on the camera, Katrina?
You're not there yet. It's
still not okay. Well, anyway. So it looks like macaroni and cheese sauce, but way, way, way better. Okay? So there you go. And if you run into the problem, you know, if maybe you do this and it gets a little bit too thick, just add a little bit of water. Or even add some of the water you used to boil the tortellini. That works as well, too. Okay? So, that's almost done. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to finish this whole bad boy up. Going to get a beautiful, nice presentation bowl, because that's very important. And then we're going to take our tortellini, and we're just going to fold that into our sauce going on right here like this.
Terry Johnson's watching.
From Thailand?
Uh-huh.
He gets a prize. What do we have for watching the furthest? Do we have anything?
Thailand?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, I know that. Now look at that. That's beautiful right there. Oh my God, Katrina. This might be the best thing we ever...
Yeah,
it might be the best thing we ever made. It tastes good too, which usually it either looks good or tastes good. We don't usually have both things happening in one recipe. Okay? So that's done. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to dish it up. Turn the power down, off, okay?
Elliot's watching.
Elliot's watching, our good friend Elliot. Got to get Elliot down here with his son and do a little music on the show, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Got to get him out of that mall gig stuff and get him to, like, private residences. Okay, here's what we got. We got our dish. Okay, we're going to take our what's this stuff called?
Tortellini.
Tortellini. Put it right there on the bowl like that. Oh, my God, this is gorgeous.
Oh, do you have
Yes,
parsley?
I do. I got it all.
Parsley?
I got it all right here, just waiting. I can't put it until actually I put the food in.
From the garden.
From the parsley from the garden, that's right. Okay? So this recipe right here makes, I would say this is probably good for probably four people. This is kind of a hearty dish right here. So you have that. So here's what you're going to do. Got some fresh parsley. Okay, so we're going to cut that up. Sprinkle that on top like that, a little parsley. Mm-hmm. And now we're going to take a little bit of Swiss cheese that we have left.
Swiss cheese.
I'm sorry.
Parmesan
cheese. We're going to take that and we're going to put a little of that on top as well. Just so you can see it, so it looks beautiful. Oh my God. Katrina, you get to eat this while I'm making the next recipe.
Lucky me.
Lucky you. Look at that. Look at this, guys. I mean, that is good. Cheese tortellini with... pumpkin Alfredo sauce. Hopefully you can see that. It is delicious. You don't have a fork over there, do you, Katrina?
No, but I'll get one.
Okay. You can go ahead and try that and let me know how it is. It actually smells really, really good. So there you go. And you can see that was very, very simple and easy to do. And it tastes good. I mean, it's amazing. Like I said, we just found this on the internet yesterday, or Katrina did. And so gosh darn good. So there you go. So we're going to get rid of this over here. And you'll know as soon as Katrina tastes it, because you'll hear something come out of her mouth like, oh my God, this is delicious, or this sucks, one or the other. How is it?
Oh, my God.
That's it. There you go. Oh, my gosh. I knew it. It's good?
Oh, good.
It's good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Man, we lucked out on that one. So there you go. So if you guys want to impress your family or friends with something to do with pumpkin this time of year, make that, okay? So you don't have to make pumpkin pie all the time.
That's good.
That's good, right? We have a lot of it left. So we'll be eating that crap for days. Right? Okay. So let's get rid of this stuff. That's what's nice about cooking in your backyard. You just throw all the crap out in the grass. You know, it doesn't matter. Okay, let's get rid of all of this. Hopefully I won't need it again, but if I do, that's okay. Okay, so there you go. One down, one to go. Another pumpkin recipe.
Mmm.
So what? It's good, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's those cheese tortellinis from Costco that are pretty good, but I think they probably sell those everywhere, right? It's not like a Costco thing.
Yeah.
Okay, any questions, comments, criticism, anything you want to know about pumpkin? If you want to know anything about Halloween, the month of October, Katrina has all the answers to any questions you might have right there on her laptop. Nothing at all, huh?
No.
Okay, this is going well.
It's a slow night, Tommy.
I know. Well, what can I do? You know? It's not like we'd be doing anything else, right? Okay, so. Spiced pumpkin fritters. Oh, Dugan's back here. Check this out. There's my dog. Here's my dog. Here every week. You know how we get to see him, but he's here every week. Okay? He needs his toenails cut. Okay. Spiced pumpkin fritters. Or as Katrina likes to call them, donut holes. Or
pumpkin holes.
Pumpkin holes. So that's what this is. We're making pumpkin holes, spiced pumpkin fritters. Very simple, very easy to do. Well, everything we try to do here is relatively easy. You know, it's getting so dark I can't even see the recipe. But that's okay.
Are you going to mention that you might change the time?
Yes, probably either next week or the week after. We're going to be starting a little bit earlier. We're going to be starting at 3 o'clock California time, so that would be 6 o'clock on the East Coast, just because, you know, it's starting to get dark, as you can see here, and maybe help a little, you know, some of the people on the East Coast stay awake, you know, because a lot of times they want to watch and they just can't stay awake. So we're going to start at 3. That's going to be either next week or the week after, but we will let you know. Okay, so there you go. So we have going to do 2 cups of flour right in there like that. 1 and 2. 2 cups of plain old flour. Okay, so to that we're going to add half a cup of brown sugar. Is it a half a cup or a third of a cup? Maybe a third of a cup. Let me just see. A third of a cup brown sugar. It can be white or it can be light or it can be dark. Doesn't matter. Whatever you prefer. We're going to say a third of a cup of this is a dark brown here, packed. Okay, that's packed right now like that. Okay, following any of this? Of course you are. And what else? So we have two and a quarter teaspoons of baking powder. 2 1/4 teaspoons of baking powder. Okay, so there's 1 teaspoon, there's 2 teaspoons, and there's like about a quarter. We'll do a little bit more, and a little bit more. There you go. Well, it sounds like the dogs in the neighborhood are getting roused up again. Okay, 2 1/4, and then we're going to add a little salt and cinnamon and nutmeg. Okay, salt, cinnamon, and nutmeg. Okay, salt, like that. Nutmeg, oh, I put my nutmeg away. Where's my nut and my meg? I put them both away. I put my nut and my meg away. There it is. A bottle of nutmeg. You know what? Do you know, Katrina? I don't know this, but where do nutmeg, where does it come from? It must be like nuts that come off of a tree, right?
I think so. I can Google it.
If no one wants to know, it's not really important, I guess. Okay, so we have our nutmeg. And then going to add a little bit of cinnamon. Got a quarter of a teaspoon of cinnamon. Go light on that because it is pretty strong. Okay? So we're going to take that. Oh, you know what I forgot? I need the electric mixer.
Mm.
Yeah, I tried doing this by hand, it just doesn't work all that well. You mind getting it?
Mm-mm.
Okay, so we're gonna mix that all together like that. And I gotta figure out how I'm gonna plug this sucker in. Okay, so we have that. We're gonna put it off to the side. That's your dry ingredients. Okay, so now we're gonna mix our wet ingredients. Okay, that's gonna start off with one egg and one cup of pumpkin. There's one egg. And measure out one cup of pumpkin.
Here you go.
Okay.
You just want me to come on campus.
Oh, there you go. There's Katrina. Big round of applause for Katrina. Okay, one cup of pumpkin and one egg we got in there. So there's a pumpkin puree. How's the lighting there, Katrina? I feel like
good.
I'm a little in the dark.
Okay. Yeah, you can see you.
Okay, that's good.
Okay. I know it looks dark, but...
Okay, so there you go. So we're putting a pumpkin in. That's one cup. Okay, like that. What else? A couple of pumps. I'm mix that together. We're going to add a little bit of, I believe it's vanilla. Let me just double check here. Three tablespoons of milk and a little vanilla. So three tablespoons of milk right here. Got it already measured out. Okay. A little bit of vanilla right in here like this. Like a quarter teaspoon of that.
Brenda Robb is watching.
Brenda Robb, I haven't seen or heard from her for a couple weeks. How you doing, Brenda? Nice to see you. Is lovely Mike with her? The lovely Michael Robb from the Robb Estate. Let me see what else I got here. Tablespoon of vanilla, melted butter, pumpkin. Okay, got it all. Okay, so you have your wet. Oh, butter. I'm going to do two tablespoons of melted butter right in here like that. Okay, almost forgot about the melted butter. So there you go. So wet in one, dry in the other. Okay? So what I'm going to try to do here now is I'm going to plug this my mixer in here. I don't have an extension, so hopefully I have enough cord in here. Let's see here. Where's Tom? If you hear if the lights go dim and the smoke comes up, you'll know what happened.
You know what's really good in this sauce?
What?
The shallots.
Oh, you can taste the shallots?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I would use shallots instead of like regular onions because they're not as strong, a little bit sweet, right, Katrina?
Mm-hmm.
I learned that today. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to take the wet, we're going to put it in the dry. Okay, wet into the dry. Are we all following me on this? Wet into dry. So there's the wet. And like I said, I tried whipping this by hand. It's a little much, so use a mixer if you can. Plus, it's always fun to use electrical devices whenever you're cooking. So let's put that right in there like that. See what happens. And it's going to be almost like a... it's going to be on a little bit of on the thick side, if you get it right. So while you're doing this, you want to make sure that you have your oil set about 365, 375 degrees, because they're going to be dumped in the oil, just like a regular donut, okay? And if you don't have a deep fryer, which I would highly suggest, look at that, crawling up the mixer. Get down. Okay, let's try that again. Sometimes that happens, you know? It tries to get out of the bowl. Well, that's going to be a nice mess to clean up right there. Okay? Dang. Okay.
Brenda says, hello, Tom and Kat. What are you making?
That's a good question. Things with pumpkin. Okay, so as you can see what's going on here. Oh, I know why this didn't happen when I was practicing, because I only made a half a batch.
Oh.
See, now I'm making a full batch. Has nowhere to go.
Put it on higher.
What?
Higher.
I don't think that's going to help.
That's
weird. There you go. Why is it doing that?
Put it on.
Okay. Slowly. Okay. Oh, man.
Oh.
Okay. Anyway, you get the idea. So it's all mixed. Man, I'm going to need a shower after this one. Okay, so that's... Okay. So scrape as much of that off as you can. Maybe the bat may have just made a little bit too much. It's good, though. So let's get a little bit of a stir here.
You got it all over your apron.
I know.
It's a good thing you're wearing it.
Good thing I'm wearing an apron. Okay, so there you go. So it's all mixed up there. The consistency, as you can see, or maybe you can't see, it's like that. It's kind of doughy, but that's okay. That's how you want it. Okay, so you got your fryer. Oh, you know what else I forgot, Katrina?
What?
I forgot the melon baller.
Oh,
man. Okay. Thank God I do the show from home. If I was like out somewhere in public, I'd be screwed right now. I'd be screwed. But look at it. I got some pumpkin right on me. Okay. So anyway, you can use a teaspoon or you can use a melon baller. Okay. I like this here. This is about an ounce size right here. So anyway, what I'm going to do, I'm going to just start taking these and just dropping them in the hot oil. Okay. That's about right. Okay. So probably put like 5 or 6 of these in at a time. If you don't have a fryer, like I was saying, it's a worthwhile investment. But if not, you just buy a pan, put it on your stove. Just keep an eye on it because you know what? Good way to burn the house down. Okay? You don't want to do that. So just start filling this thing up here. Okay? And that's about it. So all you have to do when they're done, and let this cook. These want to cook probably about three or four minutes. You don't want them to be doughy inside. You know, when you bite into them and you have all that dough, you don't want that. So we're going to just do that now. So while they're cooking, what we're going to do is you want to make a couple of little toppings for it. Okay? What we're going to do here is we're going to do a little bit of sugar. Just regular plain old sugar. Or a little cinnamon sugar. Okay? So we'll do sugar and cinnamon sugar. Okay? Oh, yeah, and I was just thinking. Oh, yeah, I already put that in there. Okay. So just add a little bit of sugar. Not a lot. Just enough, okay? And the fritters already have sugar in, so you don't have to do too crazy. And cinnamon's a pretty strong spice anyway. So that's good. So they're cooking. So when they come out, all you want to do is drain them, roll them in the flour, and eat them. They're really good to eat right out of the fryer, I think. Right, Katrina?
Yeah.
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 Any questions, comments, anything?
No.
Nothing. Probably just kind of a slow night here.
It is.
Oh, well, what are you going to do? You know what? So we're just going to stir these up a little bit.
We've only got 3 people on here.
Thanks for that. Okay. But you know what? There's 3 more people than we had at 4 o'clock.
Right?
That's the way you got to look at it. It's all good. And these are the true fans right here. Mm-hmm. It's the true fans. So maybe 3 o'clock will make a difference, maybe not.
Maybe, yeah.
We'll see. Maybe. Maybe, yeah. Maybe, no. Okay? So here's what we got. So they're in there. They're cooking. We're going to give them 1 more minute. We're going to pull them out. You guys can go home and go to bed. Maybe you already are at home. You don't have to do that. So there you go. So we had our tortellini, cheese tortellini with Alfredo pumpkin sauce. Very good.
You might want to show the audience again. Some people join late.
Oh. It's kind of dry now. I've got a skin on top of it.
Oh, but
maybe you should put this at the wall for Darrow and Paul. Put it on a wall for Darrow and Paul. Now, I have more sauce in there, too.
Okay.
But anyway, there it is. This was a good one. This was a good one.
Yeah, it was really good.
And you know what? If you guys are really all Etsy and stuff, you can buy your own pumpkin and grind it up and make your own pumpkin puree if you want. Doesn't sound like a lot of fun to me, but so anyway, we're gonna take the fritters out. Look at them; they puffed all up.
They look like little pumpkins.
They look like little pumpkins. Yeah, maybe put little faces on them. Okay. So there you go. So drain the grease, and if you want, sometimes you know they have little nipples on the top. If you want to cut those off so they're round, so when you go and roll them in the flour or the sugar. They're easy to coat. Plus the little things you cut off, they're a good little snack.
Oh, yeah.
They're good. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. Got a few of these here, so we're going to mix it up. Got a little plate here. Have our sugar. Have our cinnamon sugar. So let's take them. And when you roll them in here, just push down nice and hard so all the flour or all the sugar sticks. Okay. There's that one.
Okay. Smells so good.
I know. If you can only smell them.
It smells like the fair.
This would be a good fair food, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If it ever comes back.
If it ever comes back. Maybe we'll never see the fair again. Okay. So you guys, so we have some regular sugars. Let's do a couple cinnamon sugars right here. What else could you put in there besides the cinnamon sugar?
I was trying to think. Powdered?
Oh, yeah, you can also kind of lightly do a little powdered sugar on them, too. That would be good. Okay. So there you go.
Chocolate?
chocolate? I don't know. That's kind of a stretch. I don't know if I go that far. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So there you go. Look at these. I don't know if you can see them up close or not. But that's it. That's the fritters right here. I'm going to bite into one right now. I think they're going to be pretty hot. But let me just... Mmm. You see that? That's perfect.
Mm.
Perfect fritter. You want to try one, Katrina?
In a minute.
Okay, in a minute.
Yeah.
Delicious. And you know what? What's kind of nice is this could have been the two best things we've ever cooked in the last 18 episodes, and only three people here got to see that. They're special. Okay, don't forget that. So, that's it. It's our pumpkin show. October already.
Wow.
2020. So if you like any of these recipes, right down below there, the box we're watching right now, or you can go to YouTube. It's YouTube/Real Food. Subscribe. All of our shows are there. Like us. Subscribe to us. Love us. That's really all we're saying right here, right?
Because
food makes the world go round.
Exactly.
The world needs more food and more love. Right? I think that's all we need. And a lot of other shit, too, but we can only do the food and the love. So anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. My name is Tom. That's a lovely Katrina. And Dugan is somewhere. I think he might have went in, actually. Dugan went in. He may be sleeping right now, or he passed away. I can't tell. But, just standing there looking at the sunset. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. We're going to be back here either next week at 3 o'clock or the week after. Keep watching Facebook. We'll let you know what's going on. And then once we do switch to 3 o'clock, it will be that way probably through winter and as long as we want to put ourselves through this torture. It's not really torture. We love doing it. So anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. And we'll see you next time. Play the closing music.
We don't have any.
No closing music. How long can we do this joke for? We did it for 18 weeks. Anyway, thanks, guys. Bye.